Hey guys, it's iMaster, and I have the probably last PHPBB tutorial here for you today. Today what I'm going to be showing you how to do is go deeper into the customization of your forum. Now, last PHP video, I showed you how to install a custom style. If you haven't watched that video, I'd suggest go ahead and watch it now because you're going to have to use what you learned there here in this video. Alright, so basically what we're going to be doing is effectively creating a completely custom style. And there are a bunch of things that we can do once we have done that. So basically the first steps that we have to do is duplicate an existing PHPBB style. That means either SubSilver 2 or ProSilver. You cannot create a custom style from a style that you downloaded, like a custom style. You have to use one of these. So I'm going to choose SubSilver 2. I suggest you do the same because it is easiest. So I'm going to go ahead and click Duplicate, and then I'll go ahead and get info, rename it Custom Theme. So the first thing you want to do inside of this custom theme is claim ownership of it. So the way we do that is there are four files. They are called style.config, template.config, or CFG really, style.cfg, template.cfg, theme.cfg, image.cfg, and they are found respectively in each of the folders. So image.cfg right there. Inside of the image set, template.cfg is found right, shouldn't be too hard, right there. And the one for the theme is called theme.cfg. So pretty easy. And what we need to do for each of these is just open it. I'm going to choose to use Espresso to open all the files in this video because it is easiest and my preferred file opener thingy-majig. Alright, so we don't need to edit anything here except for this part right here. And this is what you're going to be looking for on all of those CFG files. So what we're going to, and this has to be consistent with all the CFG files. So you can basically just copy and paste this really. Alright, so name equals, we'll put custom theme. 2005 PHPBB group, we're going to change that to iMaster, comma, the year, and obviously your name, comma, the year. Version 1.0.0, because this is the first version. Then we would save that and do that with all of the other style.cfg files, or whatever the respective folder is. I'm not going to show you how to do that because it's pretty self-explanatory. Now, forgive me if I'm rushing into this video, guys. When I first made it, I got halfway through it, and that was at 11 minutes, so I really got to hustle. Alright, so the most basic level of customization we could do within this advanced level of customization is to go into the image set. The image set is basically almost all of the images that are used on our forum, such as the red forum, like if you've read the forum or if there's new topics or, you know, etc., etc. So you can change anything there. The most common one that you'll probably want to change is right here. That is the site logo. So to change this image and any of the images, all that you need to do is take a note of the name and create whatever image you want, making sure that it is the exact same size and that it has the exact same name and extension, right? So you can do that with any of the images found here. Now, one of the problems with PHPBB theme forums is that they often don't match your website. You know, chances are you've already created your website and you're trying to get a forum that looks like your website. Well, that's not always the easiest thing, but it can be done. The way you do that is you go into your theme and you find the stylesheet.css. Now, this is why I suggest that you use SubSilver 2, because this particular theme only has one style sheet, whereas Pro Silver has, like, a bunch. I'll show you. Pro Silver has all these style sheets. So, I prefer to edit just the one. So, we go into that. Again, I'm opening this in Espresso. And we can edit it there. So, some things to keep in mind when editing this. It's basic CSS. There are a bunch of different classes. And for someone who doesn't know CSS or HTML or the like, this can be very overwhelming. But there is one thing that I found that helps me a little bit. That is Firefox. Now, I know what you're thinking. What? Well, there's a certain add-on that you can download for Firefox. I forgot what it's called, but I will put the link in the description, as well as the link for Firefox if you don't have it. But basically, when you get your Firefox window up and you navigate to your form, there's a way to tell the ID and class details. What's what, in other words. So basically, we go under the information and click display ID and class details. And there we go. We can see that this is the header right here. This is the menu bar right here. It does push things over everywhere, but it gives you an idea of what's what and what will be changed. You could do this trial and error as well, but PHP, for some reason, takes a long time to upload. I mean, to actually get the changes to take effect. Don't ask me why. I can't tell you. But you could be trialing and erroring, I guess that's right, for a while. So that helped me when I was first doing this. Something else that helped me was a resource on the PHPBB website that basically runs you through some of the basics of creating a form. And I will obviously put a link to that in the description. So, some other things that you should do when you're updating your form, etc. Let me go ahead and set this back to normal. I'll go ahead and log in to our website, or our forum, rather. Okay, log in. Administration control panel. Log in. Proceed. Alright. So, once here, we'll obviously go into the style tab, upload our style, and then we'll see it down here. Obviously, I haven't uploaded mine, so I can't see mine. But once we go through installing it, creating, and making it the default style, you want to be sure to, whenever you change it, refresh your template here. I'm under this template tab. You can refresh it there, and that seems to make the process a little bit quicker of PHP actually updating it. Also in the themes, nothing much you can do there. Obviously, you can edit the theme there, but I don't think that makes it any faster. In the image set, there's not really much you can do here. I have it. Basically, you can assign certain images to act as other images. So, for example, the main logo. Yeah, we'll say the main logo. I have no image, but it should be site logo. So the current image is not. So basically, you can do changes within there, but that's not really of much help. And the final thing that I want to show you guys is how to purge the cache. This is really easy. All you do right here, purge the cache, run now, and that also makes the updating process a little bit quicker. So guys, like I said, this is probably my last video. I hope you got my last PHP video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any specific questions or any general questions, please, please do not hesitate to PM me. I answer all my PMs, all my comments, so you can contact me there. Thanks again, guys, for watching. Rate, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.